kripa sindhu su sampurno sarva satto upakaraka nispriho sarvato siddhyo sarva vidya visharadah sarva samsayo samschetta anulasa guru rahit.
It was the disappearance day of Srila Bhakti Prapanna Paribrajak Maharaj, who is the disciple of Bhakti Sammanda Parvat Goswami Maharaj. And that Bhakti Sammanda Parvat Goswami Maharaj, it was a disciple of Prabhupada. Not only disciple, he is the almost oldest disciple. He took birth there in Godroom. He got the chance to hear Gita Vakshapam Bhaktivinoda Thakur talking. From him, he took. So actually yesterday I wanted to speak so many things. I should remember and speak in a very nice way. Actually Guru Tattva, actually I was speaking yesterday, that those who are not Anugata unto the lotus feet of a pure, try to understand very carefully. Those who are not inclined unto the lotus feet of a pure Vaishnava Guru, they are almost like beast. Follow? Those who are not inclined 100% unto the lotus feet of a pure Guru Vaishnava, they are almost like beast. Not only beast, those beasts can do some bad activities, but those who are similar to beasts, they can come down to more low level. Those who have no controlling over their sense organ, be careful about that. Actually, without inclination, your bhajan cannot start. That is the main point, vital point. Without inclination, your bhajan cannot start. Submission, your bhajan cannot start. If bonded soul tried to take his own responsibility, if bonded soul like to take his own responsibility in his own hand, in that case he cannot find any good. On the contrary, he can go down and down more deep into darkness, because he wanted to search and get some good. You will have to give all your responsibility into the hand of a pure Guru Vaishnava. Otherwise, not possible. I was bound to quote one sloka by Naraji Maharaj. Kalo karmo gunadhino deho ayam pancha bhautika. I told you. Kalo karmo gunadhino deho ayam pancha bhautika. Katham anyangstu gupayet sarpagustho yathapara. Naraji Maharaj speaking in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj, "Hey Rajan, why you are expressing anxiety? Why you are crying? You think you can save somebody? In this material world, nobody can save. Nobody can save you. In this material world, nobody can save you. Not your husband, not your wife, not your children, not your father, mother, nobody. Nobody can save you. Be careful." Naraji Maharaj speaking in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj, "Hey Rajan, why you are crying, expressing, you know, anxiety? You think you can save? You can save? Nobody can save. Actually, all Jivatma, they are getting some body according to their previous activities. All Jivatmas, they are getting one and another, one after another, new bodies to suffer good and bad. This way they are suffering. Who can stop suffering? Nobody can stop suffering. It's a must. It's a must. Nobody can stop suffering. Actually, Krishna Bhagavan also less interested about your activities. If you are not going to do bhakti, only if you are busy with sinful activities and, you know, punya and pap, virtue. Vice and virtue, if you are busy, Krishna is less interested. Because Krishna already speaking in Gita, Nadatte kasachit papam nachaiva sukritim vibhum agyanena avritam jnanam tenam yanti yantabha. Nadatte kasachit papam nachaiva sukritim vibhum. If somebody going to do some good activities or bad activities, Krishna are less interested about that. Vibhu not going to get anything, is less interested. Only jivas, according to their own activities, going to create a new world, again death, again nupadis. But I can do whom to blame? Nobody to blame. Nathamadaka already told, you can remember, punno se sukher dham naloyo tarnam. You are thinking about pious activities. What you can do? You can go up to heaven. You can go, finally up to heaven you can go. But from heaven, you will have to again come back here. In this material, why? Krishna speaking, khune khine punne mattalokam vishanti. Khine punne, when your punna is over, then your demigods can throw you. Hey, go! All your money over. You cannot pay. Again, go down. Throw. Khine punne mattalokam vishanti. So those who are pure devotee, they never think about punna and papa, they are less interested. But be careful, when Yudhishthira Maharaj hearing from Naraji Maharaj, that case was totally different. Why? Andha Dhritarashtra gone from palace, where gone? They cannot trace out, that's why crying. Maybe I have done some mistake, if I am, you know, that's why my elder, you know, brother, actually, father gone, maybe jump into Ganga. I have some done some wrong, maybe. In the meantime, Naraji Maharaj coming and speaking, giving warning. Hey Rajan, why you are crying? You think you can send somebody who is going to die? Nobody can die. Nobody can die if Supreme Lord is there. If Supreme Lord going to save you, you can be saved. Now actually, by this advice, Naraji Maharaj going to give the picture of this material society. Follow this point. Material society. In this material society, as if in this material society, a snake going to catch a frog, you know? You have seen? I have seen. One frog is there, snake catch this frog. Fox, stop. Stop. Cannot speak anymore. And the snake going to swallow. Till then, that fog is, you know. Naraji Maharaj giving, you know, all Jivatma like that fog, who is already into the mouth of Mirtu, death. Snake. Going to swallow you. Swallow mean? Check inside. So why you are crying? But be careful, yesterday I was speaking, I like to speak this way, that actually a Vaishnav can save you 100%. A Vaishnav can save you. Though Naraji Maharaj saying, who can save whom? Yes, I know, there is the picture of material world, this material world. But 100% a pure Vaishnav can save you, who is powerful. Not you only, thousands of people. It is written there in Kirtan. You know in Kirtan what is written? Brahmanda tarite shakti dare jane jane. Narottam Thakur. Whole Brahmanda they can percept. Deliver. What to speak about you and me? Yes. Brahmanda tarite shakti dare jane jane. Eh? Narottam was speaking? So 100% right. Those pure devotees like Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all pure boys. They can emancipate thousands of people bonded soul. Yes. So we can believe. So we can serve a pure Vishnu. We can serve a pure Vishnu. If we can serve, then ultimately we can see this material bondage is over. We are going up and up in bhajan. we can do nice bhajan. Follow what I say? This way, actually, I want to say so many things, actually. Time is very limited. Also, actually, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj speaking, those who are going to speak Harikatha very heavily, it's one kind of medicine. You cannot advise doctor, you can give me sweet tonic. You cannot speak this, you are foolish, number one. Or a doctor like to prescribe this, you will have to take it. So those pure devotees going to speak heavy Harikatha. So if you can catch, take that medicine, very shortly you can recover. But this, I wonder, I mean, Jagannath Das Babaji was speaking, those who are speaking very heavily Harikatha, like to cut your material bondage, oh my God, those material people think that he is enemy. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj speaking, we are very unlucky. We think that that pure Vaishnava is enemy. He is speaking this way. Oh, Jagannath Das Babaji crying. They think that pure Vaishnava would like to express a Karuna, sympathy, like to deliver. But the thing is, enemy. He is speaking this heavy way. And no Vaishnavata, humbleness. Huh? What do you think? Kesav Goswami don't have humbleness? Santu Goswami don't have any humbleness? You have humbleness? Because you are cheating people? You are humbleness? Very sweet word you are speaking? Oh my God! You should not speak this way. Bindavan Das Thakur wanted to kick. I am giving so many arguments, still they are not ready to accept, then I am going to kick them there on their head. So you think he has no humbleness? Prabhupada speaking, Bindavan Das Thakur is the topmost, you know, guru, Acharya in a Gaudiya line. But you are going to speak this way? He like to kick? What is that? I like to give one example. You can understand a Vaishnava is so humble. A Vaishnava is so, you know, merciful. I can give you one example. One day Sanatan Goswami, going to take bath in Jamuna. Then there, Jamuna taking bath, in the meantime, he find one scorpio. You know, cutting, poison, you know. Scorpio. Fall down in water. Sanatana Goswami says, catch the scorpio and put in the branch. He is going to die. In the meantime, 3-4 times bite. So much burning poison, heavy poison. Sanatana Goswami taking bath. Again he fall down, scorpio again fall down. Again catch and put in, you know, branches of the tree. Once Brahman taking bath there, he says, oh my God, what you are doing? It's poisonous. It's poisonous creatures, like snake. You should kill him. Kill. You should kill. You like to save? Sanatan Gosai is speaking. Actually, what that scorpio have, he is going to give me. He has poison. He like to give me poison. What I have, by the mercy of Krishna, I have mercy. I like to give mercy. You see, he has poison. And the scorpio has poison, like to give me poison. So I have all the kripa, karuna, by the mercy of Krishna, I like to sow, to save him. So what use? You see, a Vaishnava is so merciful. But you cannot believe. You think Vaishnava is very cruel, because he is going to give me punishment. But be sure I can discuss this point in Puri, at the appearance day of Prabhupada. To give punishment and to give kripa, both capabilities there with Vaishnava. Vaishnava can do both anugraha and nigraha. Anugraha means kripa, and nigraha means punishment can give. Both. Only Vaishnava can give. No material people can give. It can become jivhingsha. Only Vaishnava can. Follow. Only Vaishnava can give. It is possible for Vaishnava. Because, you know, already Rupa Goswami told, Bacha Vegam Manasaha Krodha Vegam Udarapasta Vegam. Eh? Already told? Etana Vegana Jo Visha Heta Dhiraha Sarvama Pimam Pithabim Swasishyat. He can make disciple thousands of people in this bonded. He has this capacity. But a bonded man cannot give initiation to anybody. He has no capacity to deliver him. Hello? Rupa Goswami already giving. He has his power. Shash, you know? He can control. Shashan mean? Shashan mean? A shashan mean, this word coming from Sanskrita. Shash, shash dhatu coming means shashan. Shashan mean? If you never like to be controlled by Guru Vaishnav, how you can expect that you can go to the transcendental world? Follow what I say. If you never like to be controlled by Guru Vaishnava, Guru Maharaj is giving his, hey, don't do it. You will have to obey. Follow. Shashan mean? Shishya mean? Shishya, this word coming from Shash Dhatu. Shash Dhatu, Shishwa. If disciple not going to obey Gurudev, his instruction, he is not at all disciple. Now tomorrow I can discuss first. I can start with the discussion. What do you mean by Sampradaya? Now I like to stop today with final touch. That disciple, externally he cannot speak big Siddhanta, nothing. He cannot speak Harikatha. But at least he is having big love of Guru Vaishnava. He is actually 98 year, 99 year. And I am almost half age. Yes? 60 now. At that time when he leave body, that one, my age was more, 8 years less, 7 years, 6 years back, that time I was less. So, but still he respects me so much. So much he respects me all the time. He respects me so much. Or his godbrother, you can remember, Udala Sagar Maharaj, you know, Nilgiri I go, leave body I run, night time I was sick. That his godbrother. He loved me very much. Actually, people misinterpret this point. Who is simple? Who is humble? Who is simple? Ordinary people cannot understand. They always try to misinterpret to get some undue advantage. Common people, they like to get some undue advantage out of this point because I am speaking very sweetly, so I am humble. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Narottama Thakur never speak this way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Antare Vahire Samabhavahar Amani Manodaman Habo. We think one foolish person is there. Hey, he is very simple man. Very saral. Not that. Saral means, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, who is getting full kripa of Guru Vaishnava, having nice tattva, but having no humble attitude, 100% no abhiman. At the same time, what happens? Who is going to speak the same thing what he feel from heart? Follow. He is simple. He is very like child. My Guru Maharaj. Like child. Even a five years old child is not so simple like my Guru Maharaj. I can touch Bhagavatam and speak this truth. I can give you one example. How simple my Guru Maharaj. So like child, not child even. Even one child, if you give some toffee or biscuit, if his brother is there, if you say, give your brother, no, I cannot give. That small boy can say. But if I give example, my Guru Maharaj appearance, their disappearance, his copy, I can speak. So simple. So humble, so simple. In train, ordinary train, no money, nothing. Very, very, you know, niskinchan, going by train. Somebody, just they ask him, Maharaj, where are you going? Actually, I am going to Midnapur. Oh, I am also going to Midnapur. Really? Where? Oh. So, I can take you with me. That man speaking. Maharaj, okay, I am lucky. I am old age. You can help me. Then after reaching Howrah, and sitting in that man speaking, Maharaj, you sit. I can get ticket for you. Midnapur. Maharaj said, no, I can buy my ticket. No, Maharaj, you sit, you are old man, you sit in chair. Maharaj sitting in chair. And then take money. No, you know. Take money. Take money. Then give 50 rupees to get ticket. That man gone, no ticket, nothing, he was a cheater. Now you can say he can understand everything. Why he cannot understand? You can put this question. That man gone. After half an hour gone, 1 hour gone. Where that man gone actually? Maybe there is big queue in line. That man is cheater, gone with money. Goes, maybe he can come, I will have to wait another 1 hour. He's waiting, not coming. Guru Maharaj can understand, but Guru Maharaj busy with Krishna Lila, Chintan. He is not going to play his head. If he can come down in this material level and look, he can understand his cheater. But Guru Vaishnav cannot understand. Why? They are traveling in this level. They are less interested. Somebody, someday, some thief going to take some money from the pocket of Guru Maharaj. And some Maharaj was there, he's shouting, Maharaj, Maharaj, the thief taking. That time Guru Maharaj was going to give garland to Jagannath in Rath, chanting and doing kirtan in very ecstatic mood. When that Maharaj, Puri Maharaj, his name is also Puri Maharaj, he's shouting. Guru Maharaj become angry. Hey, stop! You're shouting? Hey, he's taking money. Let him take. What I can do with money? You are breaking my mood. Let him take money. Thief taking money. Guru Maharaj said, let him take. You are, you know, so nice moment. I am loving Jagannath. I am doing kirtan. You are, Maharaj, take your money. Huh? Let him take money. Useless. So you see, this is a mood. So yesterday in Advaita Pita I was speaking, that day, I mean. So actually that Maharaj, last moment, call me, come, call Sam Baba. I like to see him. I go, I find he's, you know, shaking, almost going to die. And all devotees, his disciples, they're giving cool oil. Ayurvedic oil and giving water. His body is in trouble. He with full knowledge, talking with me, one by one is putting question. One by one putting question before me. I was feeling very sorry. Maharaj, you know, almost going to leave body and shaking and still speaking with me. After that, somehow I give answer in appealing mood. You are senior to me, you are actually 98-99 years. I am actually half your age. Anyway, you respect me, love me, that is my property actually. Now I pay dandavat to him, I say you think about Krishna, Guru Varga. Then after I go, that night, Maharaj, leave body. Maybe 12 o'clock night, leave body. So they invite me. I never like to go anywhere. If I find some potency, if I go some speak Harikatha, but for prasadam everything I cannot go, as it's not possible for me. I have some rules and regulation. Anyway, I like to stop here. If you have any question, you can put in front of me. If you have any question, no question. Vancha kalpadurva shikhi pasindhi bhajupati dhanang pavana bhavishna.
Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada used the math system he saw from Madhavacharya, then he also used Srila Bhakti Siddhanta
Saraswati.
What? The math system.
Yes. Actually, it was also the order of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur clearly writing in Kirtan, Matmandi Dalanbari Nakaro Piyas. Don't try to make any temple, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. It was for whom? For we all, common people. But at the same time, Krishna speaking in Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, Bhagavan speaking in front of Buddha, Man Mandir Kare Dhiram. You must make big temple. Krishna Bhagavan giving instruction to Buddha, Man Mandir Kare Dhiram. You can make a big temple. So this contradiction apparently. So I can explain someday. Bhaktivinoda Thakur not speaking lie. For Prabhupada, everything is possible. But if even a bonded soul going to make in a temple out of his money power, he is a total failure. Because out of money power, he cannot make temple. Temple is Anantadev can come. Deity means Radha Govinda Gaur Hari can come. That's not possible. Prabhupada many times speak. Out of money power, he cannot establish any temple. Not possible. Any deity. Be careful. Money power is not all. Maybe you have billions of dollars, but you cannot find any right application of that money. Follow? So Niskinchan Vaishnava, like Prabhupada, always speaking, that much money is sufficient. As and when I need, Krishna can send, I can use. I cannot put in hand, and dacoit can come and cut my throat, but fighting. No use. Eh? What use?